बांटने वाले महफिल सजाएंगे। नाउ दिस स्टेटमेंट व्यूअर्स बाय प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी इन थाने इन पोल बाउंड महाराष्ट्र हैज ट्रिगर्ड अ बिग पॉलिटिकल स्टॉर्म। ही सेड दिस व्हाइल टारगेटिंग द कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड इट्स एलाइज इन महाराष्ट्र। ही सेड द ओनली मिशन ऑफ द कांग्रेस पार्टी इज टू डिवाइड पीपल एंड रूल एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी नीड टू मेक यूनिटी आवर शील्ड। लिसन इन।
कांग्रेस और उसके साथियों का एक ही मिशन है, समाज को बांटो, लोगों को बांटो और सत्ता पर कब्जा करो। इसलिए हमें अतीत से सबक लेना है, हमें हमारी एकता को ही देश की ढाल बनाना है। हमें याद रखना है, अगर हम बटेंगे तो बांटने वाले महफिल सजाएंगे। हमें कांग्रेस और महाअघाड़ी वालों के मंसूबों को कामयाब नहीं होने देना है।
Now, soon after this, RSS chief Mohan Bhagwat affirmed that India is a Hindu Rashtra and the Hindu society must unite for its security by eradicating language, caste, regional disparities and conflicts. Listen in.
हम भारत माता के पुत्र हैं और इसलिए भारत माता के लिए जिएंगे मरेंगे, लेकिन भारत में भारत के लिए जिम्मेवार समाज कौन सा है? वो हिंदू समाज है, क्योंकि भारत हिंदू देश है, हिंदू राष्ट्र है। परंपरा से, प्राचीन समय से यहां पर हिंदू लोग रहते आए। हिंदू नाम बहुत बाद में आया, लेकिन उस समय से जो रहते आए थे उन्हीं को हिंदू नाम मिला।
Now viewers, this call for unity as given by the Prime Minister seems similar to what Yogi Adityanath, the UP Chief Minister, said a few weeks ago. He said this while addressing a gathering in Agra, while citing the example of Bangladesh. Listen in.
से बढ़कर भी कुछ नहीं हो सकता, कुछ नहीं हो सकता। और राष्ट्र तब सशक्त होगा जब हम एक रहेंगे, नेक रहेंगे, तभी नेक रहेंगे। बटेंगे तो कटेंगे। आप देख रहे हैं ना, बांग्लादेश में देख रहे हो ना, तो वो गलतियां यहां नहीं होनी चाहिए। कटेंगे तो कटेंगे, एक रहेंगे तो नेक रहेंगे, सुरक्षित रहेंगे और समृद्धि की पराकाष्ठा को पहुंचेंगे।
Now, Prime Minister's call for unity is being seen as divisive by the opposition. However, the BJP has echoed PM's sentiment. Listen in.
जो आदमी कपड़ों के आधार पे, भाषा के आधार पे, खानपान के आधार पे लोगों को बांटता हो, उसकी पूरी राजनीति लोगों को और समाज को बांटने और विवाद पैदा करने में हुई हो, उससे मुंह से ऐसी बातें सुनकर हैरानी होती है। प्रधानमंत्री को कहिए पहले अपनी राजनीति ठीक करें, फिर ये देश सुधर सकता है। आपकी राजनीति की वजह से आज देश की ये स्थिति है।
तो मोहन भागवत जी को 11 साल के नरेंद्र मोदी की सरकार में क्या हिंदू सुरक्षित नहीं है ऐसा लग रहा है? महाराष्ट्र में हिंदू सुरक्षित नहीं है ऐसा लग रहा है? 10 साल की सरकार महाराष्ट्र में इनकी हो गई है तो क्या हिंदू सुरक्षित नहीं है? हिंदू के नाम से वोट मांगा है, उसी हिंदू को तुमने आत्महत्या करने लगा है। किसान में सबसे ज्यादा हिंदू है, बेरोजगार युवाओं में सबसे ज्यादा हिंदू है, गरीबों में सबसे ज्यादा हिंदू है, तो किसकी बात कर रहे हैं? तो इसका भी जवाब उनको देना पड़ेगा। जो बीजेपी को सपोर्ट करती है आरएसएस और उनकी सरकार है, उन्हीं के शासन में अगर हिंदू खतरे में है और हिंदू संगठन मोर्चे निकालते हैं तो उसका जवाब तो इनको ही देना है। तो इसलिए मोहन भागवत जी का इशारा नरेंद्र मोदी की तरफ है कि किसके तरफ है, उन्हें स्पष्ट करना चाहिए।
वेल, देयर इज नो डाउट, प्राइम मिनिस्टर इज वेरी राइट व्हेन ही सेज जब हम बटेंगे तो बांटने वाले महफिल से जाएंगे, बिकॉज कांग्रेस हैज बीन प्लेइंग ए डिवाइसिव रोल इन दिस कंट्री एंड दे हैव ट्राइड टू डिवाइड द कंट्री ऑन नेम ऑफ कास्ट, कलर एंड क्रीड एंड ऑल्सो ऑन रिलीजन। सो कंट्री नीड टू बी गेदर एंड फाइट दीज डिवाइसिव फोर्सेस।
And this is our big debate this evening. Joining us on the broadcast is Pradeep Bhandari, BJP's national spokesperson. We also have with us Dr. Nikul Patel, who is the leader of the Congress Party. Good evening. Appreciate both of you for joining us here on Times Now. Dr. Nikul Patel, I'd like to begin the discussion with you. My question is very simple and straightforward. What's wrong with all people of India being united?
See, firstly, I would like to quote the Pradhan Mantri's statement that nobody should get divided. And nobody should try that thing. But if you see the Bharatiya Janata Party politics, how they have divided the Shiv Sena in Maharashtra and NCP in the Maharashtra, and then they form the government. The Prime Minister is telling that if you get divided, then they want to go for the power. But it's ultimately the philosophy of Bharatiya Janata Party to break the opposition, to get into it, to divide them, and to get into power. We are not like that. We are over here always.
So shouldn't the opposition also take this message of the Prime Minister and stay united? Because what is he trying to say? What is the message that he's trying to give? That we all should stay united.
Yeah, that is the good message given by the Prime Minister, that everyone should stay united if you want to fight against Bharatiya Janata Party philosophy. Because in the country, the way the Bharatiya Janata Party is ruling and how the Prime Minister is used to work against the opposition is rightly being reflected in his speeches. So over here, we would like to tell everyone that just listen to our Prime Minister, that we should not divide ourselves. Otherwise, Bharatiya Janata Party wants to get into power. And then if we stay united together,
so,
then definitely...
So before I go across to Mr. Pradeep Bhandari for a quick response, Dr. Nikul Patel, you are saying you have no objection. So if I've understood you correctly, Mr. Dr. Nikul Patel, you're trying to say you have no objection to this point that the Prime Minister has made today. It's an important message. We all should stay united because, you know, we have seen many other leaders from the India bloc, specifically INDIA bloc, trying to suggest that it's a very divisive comment by the Prime Minister.
To me again?
Yes.
Yeah. See, definitely, the divisive policy is of Bharatiya Janata Party and they want to divide the people and want to get into the rule. And it's not only Maharashtra, but in the entire country, you can see wherever the government is formed by Bharatiya Janata Party, they used to do the divisive politics.
Okay.
Now, you see that how Maharashtra government was formed and they find difficulty into Lok Sabha election. So now what Pradhan Mantri wants to try to say that the Maharashtra upcoming election, everyone must stay united. And if it is happening so, then definitely a good government is going to form. We welcome the speech of Prime Minister, but he should start with himself.
Okay. Mr. Pradeep Bhandari, how will you like to respond? Because it's interesting here, Dr. Nikul Patel seems to be, you know, seeing what Prime Minister said as a positive message, but other leaders from the Congress, you know, from other political parties in the opposition are seeing what PM has said as a divisive statement. How will you respond?
Well, thank you so much for having me on your show. See, the essence of what the Prime Minister has said is against the Congress Party, in particular the senior leadership of the Congress Party in the Gandhi family, because the genesis of the politics of the Congress Party is vote bank politics. Now, let me take back to you in history when Rajiv Gandhi was the Prime Minister, if you remember the Shah Bano movement, where the Congress Party, because of vote bank compulsions, overturned the verdict of the Supreme Court. When the Congress Party under Sonia Gandhi was in power, they brought the infamous communal violence bill where the Hindu was always the aggressor. So if you look at the trajectory of the Congress Party, its only focus is not uniting the 140 crore Indians, its focus is only on uniting its vote bank. Let me give you a simple instance from Maharashtra. This is the letter from the Congress Party where it refuses to call Sambhaji Nagar as Chhatrapati Sambhaji Nagar, and if you remember very clearly, Sharad Pawar also had made a statement that if the MVA government comes into power, they will rename a lot of these historical cultural sites which is there. So the genesis of the Prime Minister's statement is that our opposition today is not focused on developmental politics, it is focused on only vote bank politics. Let me give you another instance and with which I will end my part. You know, if you remember what happened in Bengal, which is what I was seeing on the Times Now report, an 11-year-old Hindu daughter was... Congress Party, which speaks about ladki hun lad sakti hun, did not raise a single comment or a statement on it, only because the aggressor is from a community which the Congress Party believes that if it raises the voice, it will hamper the vote bank. So even if it comes to heinous crimes like rape, the Congress Party is selective only because of its vote bank compulsions, and that is what the Prime Minister precisely said. Ultimately, we believe in politics of 140 crore Indian. That is where it is sabka saath. सबका विकास एंड वी आर मेकिंग द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया अवेयर अगेंस्ट दिस हिटलर्स गोबेल्स फिलोसफी विच राहुल गांधी इज फॉलोइंग विच इज रिपीट अ लाई 100 टाइम्स सो दैट इट अपीयर्स एज ट्रूथ एंड दिस इज व्हाट वी आर मेकिंग द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया अवेयर अबाउट एंड कॉन्शियस अबाउट.
डॉक्टर निखिल पटेल प्लीज रिस्पॉन्ड बिकॉज यू नो व्हेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑल्सो मेड दैट स्टेटमेंट ही मेड इट वेरी क्लियर विच हैज बीन आर्टिकुलेटेड बाय प्रदीप भंडारी एज वेल. प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी सेड दैट इट्स कांग्रेस एंड इट्स एलाइज हु हैव बीन डिवाइडिंग एंड बिकॉज दे वांट टू रूल एंड अगेंस्ट दिस काइंड ऑफ अ पॉलिसी द कंट्री शुड स्टे यूनाइटेड.
See, Mr. Pradeep rightly wants to portray the philosophy what Bharatiya Janata Party wants to reflect into the country of divisive politics among the people of the country. And that is how they want to rule. Now, that they have implemented into the political environment by dividing the people of the same party into the groups and then coming into the rule. I would rightly disagree with him that Congress is doing such activity. We are not like that. Bharat Jodo Nyay Yatra and Bharat Jodo Yatra were the rightly example by Rahul Gandhi where he wants to bring the people of the country together and the Nyay. And okay. Nyay, what we are telling is that everyone should get equal opportunity, equal right and equal platform and equal law for everyone. And that is not happening and that is why whatever Prime Minister is telling, we are...
Pradeep Bhandari wants to come in. Yes.
But they want
respond,
to
please.
My request is that Bharatiya Janata Party must start this, that they must not divide people into name of religion, into name of faith, into name of politics.
But here, okay. Prime Minister did not mention any religion, any community. He said, we all need to be united. Pradeep Bhandari, isn't it?
That is what they are doing. That they must start
the
this.
The okay, issue
Dr. Nikhil Patel, you made your point.
The
yes.
issue is, Dr. Nikhil, I heard you. Thank you.
Dr. Nikhil Patel,
you rightly
you
said
made
the issue
point.
Is when we speak about illegal in.
Go ahead.
The issue is that when we speak about illegal infiltrators, the Congress party thinks that we are speaking about a community because the Congress party equates illegal infiltrators to a particular community. It is the Congress, if you remember when Manmohan Singh ji was the Prime Minister, he said that the right to resources belong to one particular community. The Congress party should be the last party which is talking about breaking parties. Please go back to your history and look at what Indira Gandhi did with your Congress party, which it divided into two parts. So this is not a political statement which the Prime Minister said. This is a statement which the Prime Minister said. In the interest of unity and integrity, what does the preamble say? We the people of India. If the Prime Minister says that the people of India should be united, what is wrong in that? I will tell you the difference. The Congress party was speaking about Bharat Jodo Yatra. All of us remember how George Soros had given an open
call
that he wants to dislodge a government. He failed for the third consecutive time. And a representative of George Soros went to Bharat Jodo Yatra. And this is where we say that the intentions of the Congress
right.
party are not honest. It can go to divide this country on caste lines, on religious lines, in order to just come back to power. This
okay.
is what we are making the people of India aware about, because for us, nation first is the only philosophy.
Okay. All right, gentlemen, I'm completely out of time, but I heard the point of view of the Bharatiya Janata Party as well as the Congress Party on this particular issue. And viewer, this is going to be a top focus ahead as well. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us on this debate this evening. We will slip into the visit of External Affairs Minister Dr. Jay Shankar to Pakistan for the SCO summit. We are seeing politics here in India. While some are questioning the center over the diplomatic move, on the other hand, the chorus for talks with Pakistan is also growing. Now, the Union Minister, while speaking about his upcoming visit, emphasized that there's no room for talks with Pakistan. He also said that terrorism is not acceptable. Listen in.
Be for a multilateral event. I mean, I'm not going there to discuss India-Pakistan relations. I'm going there to be a good member of the SCO. But, you know, since I'm a courteous and civil person, I will behave myself accordingly. That terrorism is something which is unacceptable, and if despite a global view of it, if one of our neighbors continues to do it, then there must be a cost to them.
Even as India has completely ruled out talks with its neighbor, Hurriyat Conference Chief Mirwais Umar Farooq has said that India and Pakistan have a real opportunity at the upcoming SCO summit to break the ice and engage constructively. Added that generations of Kashmiris want uncertainty to end and want closure. Listen in.
Pakistan ne inko bulaya hai, daawat di hai. Ummeed karunga ki ye जहाँ शंघाई के बारे में उस मीटिंग में बात करेंगे कि वो दूसरी बातें भी करें कि मुल्क को कैसे हम लोग दोस्ती की तरफ चलाएं और इस नफरत को किसी तरीके से खत्म करें।
आपको मीरवाइज से बात करनी चाहिए। फारूक अब्दुल्ला क्या है, मैंने तो कहा नहीं, वो कह रहे हैं अल्लाह करे के मेरी बात तो इन्हें कभी मानी नहीं, हो सकता है मीरवाइज साहब की बात मान जाए।
So that was the reaction we got from Farooq Abdullah, the NC chief. On the other hand, viewers, opposition leaders are also saying that this is the hypocrisy of the government. Opposition claims that while the government makes strong statements against Pakistan for political reasons, it is being hypocritical by sending External Affairs Minister Dr. S. Jaishankar for an event in Pakistan.
Aap sirf देश की जनता को सेटिस्फाई करने के लिए कह रहे हैं, हम पाकिस्तान से बात नहीं करेंगे। आप पाकिस्तान में जा रहे हो, पाकिस्तान की बिरयानी खाओगे, पाकिस्तान की मेहमान नवाजी से आप वहाँ करवाओगे, आप ये कैसे मान लिया जाए कि आप पाकिस्तान से बात नहीं करोगे? आप उस टेबल पे बैठोगे जिस टेबल पे पाकिस्तान के नेता बैठे होंगे। अगर आपको बात नहीं करनी तो आपको पाकिस्तान जाना नहीं चाहिए।
Bharatiya Janata Party's decision to send Mr. Jaishankar to Pakistan exposes the hypocrisy of Bharatiya Janata Party and also exposes and raises serious concerns about the foreign policy towards Pakistan, because it was Mr. Modi jinhone kaha tha ki bomb barood ke beech mein baat nahi ho sakti, and then it was Mr. Modi jo chale gaye the Nawaz Sharif ke yahan biryani khane pure desh ko bina bataye, and it was after that ke Balakot hua, uske baad Pulwama hua. Pakistan se cross border terrorism badhta ja raha hai, situation is even worse than what it was earlier. So what's the need of sending Mr. Jaishankar to Pakistan?
And with this